Hello everyone. Welcome to the Business Performance Analytics app. I am logged in as a administrator here. And I'd like to start by orienting us all to what the app looks like. Let's look at the left-hand side menu where there's two main sections, Data Explorer and Administration. Because I'm an administrator, I have access to both sections. But if I were a typical user, I would only get access to the Data Explorer section that lets me build and edit reports. And today I will showcase first what a regular user can see and create in terms of reports in public preview. Then I will show what the administrator can do in terms of setting up security for public preview. Let's start with reports. Here, you will see all the reports that are available to me. Some of these reports I've created and some of these reports Microsoft has created. Now, the reports that Microsoft has created will be shipped right out of the box. Let's take a look at one such report. I'm going to click on Ledger Transaction List Report. This report is a Power BI report with all the fields and visuals already built for you. And you can edit these to your liking. Now, because this is a template, you cannot edit these directly. You must duplicate this report for your own version, and then you are able to edit that report. So this report just got duplicated. I'm gonna go ahead and open that duplicate report. And now I'm able to edit this duplicate version, and I'm able to add any visuals I want here. And I'm also able to edit any filters, add any fields that I want. For example, maybe I want to get rid of legal entity. I can do that. Maybe I want the visuals to look a bit different. I'm just going to pick a bar chart here, for example. Or maybe I want to add a few fields that were not available before. I can do that as well. Next thing I want to point is, how do I create a brand new report? So that's the Create Report section. I name my report, let's say, Demo Report 11. And I pick the data set that I want to create the report with, and I hit the Create Report button. And the report has been created for me. Now the report, as you can see, is a blank report, so I must start editing it, including building visuals as I showed you previously and starting adding data fields. I'm gonna add random data fields here. Let me expand this so you can see, but I'm adding random data fields here, and you can start adding those. But that will start creating my tables here. If I wanted to add any other visuals, I could start doing that here. And it will start building up my charts as well. So basically everything that you can do in Power BI, you can do here. And voila, my report got created. Now, you can also do other actions. For example, you can select a report and you can delete or duplicate that report to create a copy. I'm going to go to the administration homepage. This is a landing page for any administrator once they come into the app. This is at the top here, they can review what the app is about and they can view documentation. I'm going to close that out for now. And I'm going to start by showing you some of the actions. The first action is to validate your data. Now, when you first install the app, data is flowing from the data lake into the transformation pipeline, and you want to make sure that the data is actually flowing into your report before you start assigning users to this app and giving other people access. So you can do that through Validate Your Data. What that does is it takes you to the reports that are available from Microsoft, and you can click on any of these reports and validate that data is in fact available in these reports. And then you can also open the same report in F&O and compare your data and make sure things are working the way that you expect them to. Let's go back to the homepage. And I'll now show you how you can set up security here. First, I'll start with setting up dimension security. There's a two-step process here. The first step is to select dimensions that you want to secure on. So let me click on that. Here, you can select up to 5 dimension attributes that you want to include in report security. Public preview, you will have access to the ledger dimensions table as well as all your reporting dimensions. And you can, like I mentioned, select up to 5 here. I'm going to select an additional one so you can create security on legal entity, business unit, and cost center. The second step is to create dimension groups. Now, what do dimension groups do? They group together the dimensions that you selected in your previous step. And here you can select the values for those dimensions and assign data security to users. Go ahead and click on the new button to create a new group. I named this something, so I'm going to name it, let's say, test group 1. And I'm going to start by adding some values here. I'm going to choose an exact value because I know that I want the legal entity to be USMF, but of course you can choose other operators as well, like contains and is between. Then I'm going to choose another value for business unit. Let's say it's a specific business unit between 001 and 010. And I can go ahead and apply a couple of other criteria as well. So let's say it's going to be one business, an additional business unit, let's say 100 or 200. And I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing for cost center. So for cost center, this is the value I'm going to choose. Okay. And then I'm going to go ahead and click next, and I'm going to create my access group. All right. Now you can see that access group got created. Next step is I'm going to show you how I set up roles. And now these roles give access to reports. So let me go ahead and click the new button to set up a role. And I'm going to say it's test analyst 1 role. And this role has access to ledger transaction list report. And I see what I signed here, and I go ahead and create. And this role gets created. Next, I'm going to create add users here. I'll go ahead and click on add user. And I can search the user by name. So in my case, I want an Aurora user. And let's say I'm going to pick Aurora 16. Go ahead and click next. And I'm going to select the role that I just created for them. You could also select more than one role. And I'm also going to select the group that I just created. I believe it was test group 1. And I'm going to go ahead and complete setting up that user. And I'll have to refresh here, and that user appears.
Hello everyone. We are excited to introduce you to new Dynamics 365 Expense mobile app. This innovative solution was developed to make expense reporting more efficient and user-friendly for team members, allowing them to manage their expenses on the go. The app includes a variety of features to make expense reporting as seamless as possible, such as ability to create expenses and expense reports, OCR receipt pictures, and attach existing receipts. The app also includes the ability to save, submit, and recall expense reports, leveraging pre-configured web automation workflows to streamline the process. Additionally, the app allows team to leverage pre-configured web expense policies for compliance and oversight. The app can be customized to the specific needs of your organization. Let's dive into the product to go through some of the features. Dynamics 365 Expense mobile app is developed using Canvas Power App.
users can access it from Power App Mobile by logging in using their corporate credentials. This is supported in both iOS and Android devices. Users could also pin the application to their home screen for quick access. When the users launch the application, they will be taken to the home page, which displays a list of unattached expenses. Receipts, expenses, and reports are the three sections of the application. The receipt section displays a list of all unattached receipts. Users could switch between a tile view and a list view of their receipts. To add a new receipt, click on plus icon and then capture and save the receipt. The report section is divided into three subsections to group the expense reports based on their status. The expense section allows the users to see a list of unattached expenses, both manual and credit card transactions, and manage them. Now consider a scenario in which employees could create and manage expenses and reports. Julia is an architect working for a local firm. She recently returned from a company trip to meet with customer and learn more about the project she will be working on for the Franklin Street Bridge. She wants to get reimbursed for her trip expenses. She quickly launches the application by using the shortcut from her home screen that she had previously added. She has a receipt from the corner store. She creates a new expense now by clicking on a plus icon in the expense section. And a camera opens up for her to take a picture. She takes a picture of the receipt, validates that the receipt is properly captured, and clicks on Done. The mobile app uses OCR to analyze the receipt and populate the key information such as date, amount, and merchant name from the receipt in the new expense screen. To add more details about the expense, she can click on Add More Details button, and then the mobile app will display the list of fields that are configured in the web application. She will go to the category field and select the category as Mail. Because this is a project expense, she will go to the project ID field and search for the project by name to select the project and save the expense. She also notices that some of the expenses on her list of expenses are from credit card transactions from her recent trip. She can see that hotel expense has one policy violation, which is configured by expense administrator. She quickly reviews it by opening the expense and click on a banner at the top of the screen to see the policy violation details. She notices that merchant details are required for the expense report that is more than $100. She enters the merchant details and saves the expense, and policy violation message disappears. Now to create a new expense report, she clicks on a reports tab. She will see the list of draft expense reports. She will create the reports by clicking on plus icon and enters the report details. She will now click on attach expenses button, which will open the list of unattached expenses for her to attach them to the report. She will select a few of the expenses from her recent trip and click Done. Expenses are now attached to the report. Now she has the option of saving or submitting the expense report. She quickly goes over the information and submits the expense report. As soon as she submits the expense report, it is moved to the In Review tab. Our vision for the Expense Mobile app was to build a solution that is intuitive and effortless to use, accelerating the reimbursement process and increasing the user productivity. Today, we saw how employees can easily access the mobile app, different sections in the app, and how to capture the receipts and manage the receipts, create and modify expenses, fix policy violations, and create reports and submit them for approval.